So one of the most common things that spreadsheet experts ask about numbers is, can you do pivot tables with them? Pivot tables are kind of an expert level technique that people commonly do in Microsoft Excel. And you can't really do pivot tables in Numbers. Prior to 2013, in the original version of Numbers, you could do something called categories, which was kind of the same thing. But you can't do that anymore. However, what people are mostly looking for when they're doing pivot tables is being able to get a specific type of data from a table. And you can actually do that using some formulas in Numbers. So it's not like you can't do it at all. So let's simulate a typical use of pivot tables in the current version of Numbers. So here's a table that's got a list of sales. And you see a bunch of products and they're repeated. So you have apples, 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 and oranges, oranges, oranges. And you've got the numbers sold and the price. A typical thing you may want to do with a pivot table is say, okay, how many apples have been sold total in this table? So only take into account the rows with apples in them and then count up the number sold. So you could use sum if for this. So I could say basically, okay, what's the sums if the product column is equal to apples? And you could build that formula in another table and easily say I want it for apples, I want it for oranges, I want it for pears. But what pivot tables do is they don't rely on you actually identifying which products they are. It automatically analyzes the table and figures out, for instance, that there are three different type of products here and that it sums up the apples, oranges, and pears automatically. So let's do that because we can actually do that with formulas. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to add one more column here. So I just clicked here on this little equal sign and I'm going to add a column and that column is going to be called first. So we're going to enter a formula in here and we're going to use the match function. And here's the definition of the match function. I have it up on the right. And it says it returns the position of a value within the collection and the parameters are search for, search where, and the matching method. So search for, we're going to search for the value of the cell in column B. In this case it will be apples, but in the next row it would be oranges. Search where, we're going to search in column B, which is called the product column. So it's going to search for apples there and the matching method is going to be find value. And that's going to give me the first value, the first time it gets to it. Let's see what the results are. Now you get a $2, which is confusing until you realize, oh, you know what, it must be taking the formatting of column E from column D. So let's select column E, change the formatting to automatic, and we see it's number 2. Interesting. Let's copy and paste it in a bunch of these cells. And what do we get? Well, oranges we get 3. And we notice that the first row with oranges is 3. The first row with apples is 2. The next row, apples, gives us 2 because the first occurrence is row 2. So it's giving us the first row with that in there. So let's complete this formula by tagging onto the end there an equal sign. And we're going to use the row function. And the row function will give us the row of a cell. But if we leave it blank, nothing inside the parentheses, it will give us the current row. So in other words, 2. So we get a true here. Why do we get a true here? Because it looks up apples. It finds apples is first in row 2. And it compares that to the current row, row 2, and it says it's true. Oranges, same thing. It's in first in row 3, and this is row 3. It's true. If we go to the next row, one, we get false. Matter of fact, we pasted it in here. We're going to get mostly falses, except for trues only the first time something appears. So the first time apples appears, first time oranges appears, and the first time pears appears, because that's the only time that the first occurrence of the product is the same as the current row. Every other time it's false. So let's make sure we have that pasted in all of these. Now we have a nice true the first time each one of these products appears. Let's add another column. And this column is going to be called count by product. Now usually with pivot tables you're either trying to count something, total something up, do the sum, or get the average. And we have formulas count if, sum if, and average if for all of these. So now we just need to use those formulas here. So we'll do a formula here and we're just going to start with the sum if and we're going to see that the sum if It takes test values, condition, and sum values. So the test values are going to be, let's test everything in the product column. And if it equals the exact value of what we have in the cell in this row in the product column, then we are going to add it up and we're going to total it up based on the number sold. And we'll hit parentheses there. And we get 213. 213 is the total number of apples sold. Now if I copy and paste that here, what I get is here I get the total number of apples. Here I get the total number of oranges. Again, the total number of apples. Again, apples, oranges, pears, etc. Which is just this confusing list of numbers. What we want is it only to appear once, the first time we see each one of these. So what we're going to do is we're going to qualify this with an if statement. And the way if statements work is they take an expression and what value to put in the cell if it's true and what value to put in the cell if it's false. So we'll start off with if, and the condition will be whatever appears in column E. So it's those trues and falses that we were working on before. And if it's true, we'll put the number there. And if it's false, we're actually going to put a little quote quote for blank. So I get 213 for the first one, but if I paste it in all of these, you could see I only get that value when the column here is true. So I get apples, oranges, and pears. I get the total there. Now this already is very useful and will fulfill most people's needs for a pivot table, because whatever I do here, it's going to actually just show me these things here. I could hide this column here because it's not very useful for me to see, and just have these numbers here, and I know that the first time I see one, oh, there's a 52, oh, that's pairs. So it's the first time I see it. So now you may have already noticed there's another one down here. There's bananas as the last two, and you can see the first time it appears there it's 22. What you may want from this really is a simple table here, and you can do that using filtering. So I can select this whole table here and I can click on sort and filter, and I'll do filter and I'll add a filter, and I'll say when the first column, and I'll have it when the text is true, then only then display it. So you can see it filters it. And in addition to that, I can go ahead and I can hide these other ones here, because these don't apply. This is the number sold for the very first apples and the price sold for the very first apples. I just want the count by product. So I'm going to select these three columns here and I'm going to say hide selected columns. And the result I get just from hiding, so I'm hiding those columns, and sort and filtering, I'm sort and filtering the rows so it's only the true ones, I get the list of products and the count by product. And filters are nice because I can uncheck them here and turn them off. The hiding isn't so nice. You have to unhide all columns to get it back. So there's a couple steps there to get down to that nice small table on the big table. But it does give you a result that you can then print out or create a PDF to hand in as part of a report. So that takes care of a lot of the different things that pivot tables do for Microsoft Excel users, and you can do them now in Numbers.